Well, happening right now, we've been talking about it. The partial government shutdown is entering its second week right now, and this affects millions of small businesses across the country. Rob Bassa, the co-founder, the CEO and founder of Associated Human Capital Management, is here. Rob, it's great to have you on the show.
Thanks, Cheryl. Glad to be here on New Year's Eve.
Yeah, it's been a while, but let's talk about this because, you know, there's a lot of little intricate details that are really hurting small businesses, but the larger
right.
story is the economy.
Yeah.
If folks are not going to restaurants, they're not going out to eat, whatever yeah. they're not going to do, the dry cleaners, you take your
yeah.
pick, that really hurts mom and pop shops across the country. How
it,
so?
It does. If you just look, you think about 800,000 federal workers not getting a paycheck. They're not going to spend that money that they were supposed to make in the local businesses. It really does trickle down. Not to use the old Reagan terminology, but the simple fact of the matter is, if they don't have the money to spend, it creates a problem with all the local business owners. There's also another factor here. I mean, think about it. The regular folks that are out working in the world who miss a paycheck, they don't get to generally make up that paycheck. We have to remember that some of these federal workers that are put off are going to eventually get their paycheck. It's just delayed. It's
yeah.
those federal contractors, some of those folks that work as a contractor for the federal government. Once they miss those hours, they might not be ever seeing this money come back.
Well, the SBA actually is part of the shutdown here. And here's what they put on Facebook. They said due to the lapse of government funding, they're going to remain inactive until further notice. They apologize, but this is loans for small businesses, Rob, and that is a big problem. If you operate on short-term loans for your business, for your capital, for your
yeah.
business, that's a problem.
This is absolutely the heartbeat of America. When you shut down the SBA and you can't create new loans, what are small business owners supposed to do? It is one of the most important functions of the federal government to help small business owners. Without the SBA, some small businesses could be dead in the water. It's concerning to me as a small business owner, and it's actually going to affect my clients too.
You know, it's interesting. In 2014, after the 2013 shutdown, Stanford University did a big study on the after effects and kind of what went down. And what they said was that basically that the loss of pay during the 13 shutdown led to an estimated 2 to 4% drop in spending among government workers. And we don't know how long the shutdown's going to go, Rob. We're in our second week. We could be going into January with the new Congress coming in. They're not willing to play ball at this point, it looks like.
Well, and the president seems to be doubling down and basically saying that he's in this for the long haul. He wants his wall and he's going to get it, be damn everything else. I mean, unfortunately, it's affecting a lot more people than I think he's really taking into consideration. Look, I absolutely believe that we need stronger border controls, but at what cost to the American economy? I'm not sure we're headed in the right direction with this.
Yeah, and you're right. Small businesses and the economy are really going to probably take a hit here. Rob Bassa, it's great to have you back. It's good to see you, sir.
Thanks, Cheryl.
All right. Have a good New Year's.
You too.
All right. We've got a lot more coming up, folks. It has been a brutal year. I mentioned this earlier.